Price. Scotland when I was 18 years old, and one of the reasons was that I found my mother just absolutely, well, just forgive my language, just absolutely impossible to live with, impossible. So what happened was that when I said to my mother, "Mother, this is my gap year. We've had a few gap years here this afternoon. And I've decided to move to Canada." And she said, "And what's going to happen to me then?" I said, "But Mother, you're only 41. But anyway, I was really, really dying to go, and I searched around for a cheap one-way flight, but the cheapest one that I could find went from Troon, my hometown, to Glasgow, to London, to Copenhagen, to Gander, over the pole to Los Angeles, from Los Angeles to Portland, and from Portland to Seattle, and then to Vancouver. But I was thrilled to death, and I thought, oh, my mother will never find me. But Mother came time after time after time. And she came and spent 3 months when my first child was due to be born. So there I was, she was fine, you know, it was okay. But when I was ready to go to the hospital, she wouldn't let me out of bed. She says, "Oh, for heaven's sake, you're not going to go to the hospital already." She said, it takes hours and hours and hours and hours. And she says, "Well, when you were born, it took even longer." So I had to struggle out of bed, and she actually sat down on the bed and held me down. But anyway, Julie, one little boy came along, and Mother came along for the birth of the second child, and the third, and then when the boys were still under five, she came another time, and this time she came with my father. So my husband and I decided, let's take them for a wonderful trip up to the Okanagan. So we had a camper and the tent and, you know, all the accoutrements, and set off. There were seven of us at the time, all the way up to the Fraser Canyon, you know, absolutely magnificent, but not a free campsite to be had. So we pressed on and doubled back into Manning Park. And there seemed to be plenty there, you know, lots and lots of spaces. Of course, we had been on the road for quite some time, so the first thing that we had to do urgently was to get to the campsite washroom. So we went up this winding path to the government washroom, and you know, they're sort of Jiffy Biffies, that's what they are. And this one hadn't been empty for quite some time. So we're chattering away, and we come out, so it was nice to have finally found a campsite. But on the way down the winding path to the site, across our path ran a big baby black bear. So what did we do? Turned around, went dashing back into this lovely Jiffy Biffy, you know, five of us wheezed in. And when we got the all clear from my husband, we made our way down to the campsite again. But again came this big Mommy bear. Black and ferocious looking, right across our path. Well, for heaven's sake, that went on and on, and until the daddy bear actually crossed our path as well. So by this time, we were a little bit closer to the campsite and tried to make a run for it because there just seemed to be bears everywhere, you know, picking up the garbage. So what happened was, mother, I mean, she was afraid, of course. She came out of the Jiffy Biffy, or the Biffy Jiffy, what did I say, it was the Jiffy Biffy. And, you know, as I say, by this time we realized we were surrounded by bears. So she took to her heels and she dashed down the path and leapt up onto the camper tailgate, shutting the door behind her. And this is mother in a skirt and the pantyhose, you know, and the very dainty handbag and so on. So we said, where am I taking this? Mother said, you know, this has just been such a terrible trip, and I'm just not comfortable at all. And she said, besides that, the bears in Scotland don't pick up the garbage. We've got men to do that. And then my dad said, he said, oh, for heaven's sake, and I bet these big beasties aren't even unionized.